Hi.
Hey.
You're late.
Kiddo, you ready to go?
I'll have him back Sunday after lunch.
In the beginning, our dad moves us to this new house. You know, there's nothing in it because he's a guy, and obviously he didn't think about going shopping at IKEA or whatnot. And so he takes us to a garage sale.
Dad, you need dishes.
Dad, look! Look!
I'm a lady.
She goes to this garage sale, and she finds this box.
Cool.
Something about it catches her eye, and she's not quite sure yet what it is. So not knowing what she's in for, she buys it. And that's pretty much when the terror begins.
Why is the box so important to you?
Don't know.
It's inspired by a true story about the people who actually found a Dipper box on eBay, on the internet, bought it, and then all sorts of weird things started happening.
Whoever has had this box, owned this box, has had a series of mishaps of one kind or another and ended up getting rid of the box.
There's something in there. Well, that's weird. There aren't any seams.
What does that mean?
I think whoever made this didn't want anybody to open it.
Dybbuk box is this box that is containing this spirit, this demon. And even though it sounds sort of like mystical or like a fairy tale, it is a real thing.
The film becomes a road movie when the dad actually goes out to search for the truth in order to try to save his daughter, who's slowly being eaten up by this Dybbuk, this demon.
She is just really lost, and she does not know what she's doing. That's when the thing just takes over.
You shall not fear the terror of night, nor the...
The box is evil.
Once a box is open,
people die.
There's something inside of it that's just not right, and I don't want to give it away, but that's pretty much the whole story.
It just symbolizes the evil within. And I guess that's the setup for all these kinds of stories about possession, that we like to watch stories about people being possessed by something evil and they turn evil, and then we have to heal them again and get the evil out, and they have got become good persons and good human beings again.
My God!
I think what we tried to do with this movie was to see if we could reinvent the genre.
It's just a really an old-fashioned kind of thriller horror movie, and if we do our jobs right, we'll suck in the audience and make them care about this family.
I think it's gonna be a crazy emotional ride.
I think it's bigger than the horror genre. It's definitely scary, and it definitely will keep people on the edge of their seats. It's definitely a thriller.
You let my daughter go!